invocation of the War Powers Act by the President, I am declaring a state of martial law in this city. To the best of our knowledge, we are opposed by no more than 20 of the enemy. He's hiding among a population of roughly 2 million. Intelligence tells us that he is most likely Arab-speaking, between the age of 14 and 30, narrowing the target to 15,000 suspects. We can further reduce that number down to those that have been in this country less than 6 months. Now you have 20 hiding among 2,000. You are one of these 20 young men. You can hide among a population of similar ethnic background. Unfortunately for you, you can only hide there. And that population in the classic immigration pattern is concentrated right here in Brooklyn. We intend to seal off this borough. Then we intend to squeeze it. This is the land of opportunity, gentlemen. The opportunity to turn yourselves in. After sundown tonight, any young man fitting the profile I described who has not cooperated will be arrested and detained. There's historically nothing more corrosive to the morale of a population than policing its own citizens. But the enemy would be sadly mistaken if they were to doubt our resolve. They are now face to face with the most fearsome military machine in the history of man. And I intend to use it and be back on base in time for the playoffs. Thank you for your time.
All right, Shalom. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Rakakadash. Double honors to apostles, a great millstone, will well, and teach well. A shalom to you, Akim, out there that's pushing this truth through the four corners of the earth. All right, I want to do a quick video because, you know, this is the time we're heading to, you know, which is martial law. You know, a time where these troops are going to come in, man, and start grabbing people up, man. All hours in the night, man. 3-4 in the morning, man. The devil's going to come hard, you know, because what is it saying, Revelation 12 and 12? You know, rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. You know, the devil has short time. You know, he knows his time is short, so he's gonna do all he can right now, you know. I just got a couple of precepts, make a quick video. Second Israel, so I'm gonna start off with chapter 15, verse 14. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. Woe, that word woe means destruction. For the sword and their destruction draw nigh. And one people shall stand up and fight it against another with swords in their hand. You know, that's the modern day, you know, the weapon right now is the gun, which is Esau's blessing. For there shall be sedition among men and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes. And the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. You know, and that's the time, you know, when this devil implements that martial law. You know, you're not going to be able to go to certain places. You know, there's going to be a curfew. You know, that's, we don't know how it's going to happen, but they're going to, you know, implement it, you know. It's going to implement very soon. You know, you can see most likely this year, man. Coming months, you know. Never know. And, you know, when all hell breaks loose, you know, these devils are going to, you know, do their, you know, what's the new world order, you know, the military might. You know, start grabbing people up, putting them in camps, concentration camps, you know. Let me get that actually in Revelation. Revelation chapter, I think it's 3 and 10. Okay. No, 2 and 10. Yeah, Revelation 2 and 10. Fear none of the things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil, which is a so-called white man, shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. You know, that 10 days could be 100 days, it could be 50 days. This means, you know, a certain period of time. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life, you know. So that's the time you're going to snatching you up, you know, because you're not going to take that the MOTB, you know. You could read that on Revelation 13, 16 on down. Next precept I have is Jeremiah 30 and 7. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. You know, and who's he? The elect men, the elect women, you know, the one third, you know, certain of us would be saved, you know, and delivered. You know, certain of us would be put to death. You know, get that Revelation 20 and 4. You know, it's gonna, you know, we're coming up to hard times. Man. What's the next precept here? Isaiah chapter 59:19. So shall they fear the name of Yahweh from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood. You know, so that's when those troops, you know, that's when all hell's breaking loose, and these devils coming and kill you, man. They grab you up and whatnot. The spirit of Yahweh shall lift up a standard against them, you know. So that can go, you know, spiritual power right there, you know. Some of us are going to receive that spiritual power, you know, because there's no way this devil is going to, you know, kill all of us. You know, there's no way. And that links up right there with Daniel 12 and 1. Let me get that. So, okay, just bear with me. Reading out of the book right now, so. Alright, Daniel chapter 12 and 1. And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people, and there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to the same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. You know, so, you know, if you're on that list to get delivered, man, and you're the elect, man, that's what you push for, you know, the hopeful elect. That's what we don't say, you know, you're going to be saved 100%, because any one of us can fall out. You know, we don't know who the elect is. We don't know who the one third is. You know, all we know, we have to have faith, you know, do the work. Do the work, Yahweh Hashem El Shai. All right, my last one here is so let me read Psalms 91. It's a good one. Psalms 91 and I'll start at the top. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of Yahweh, he is my refuge and my fortress. My power in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from this snare of the flower, Sakya, and from the noisome pestilence. You know, that's what the nukes, man. That's when the destruction happens. That's right before our deliverance, man. Out of this hole. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. You know, the truth of the Bible, the truth of the scriptures. You know, and when he said he shall cover thee with his feathers and under his wings, you know, that's the chariots, man. You know, that's our, you know, protection. So you can't dodge a missile. You can't, you know, if you're stuck on this place, you're done. You know, verse 5, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fleeth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. Well, that's the missiles, man. That's the missiles. That's when this place is done. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. So none of those plagues, none of those destructions are going to come near us, man. We're going to be protected by Yahweh, Hashem El Shai. Only what thy eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. The reward of our enemies, man. So-called white man known as Esau. Hamites, man. So known as Africans. Ishmael. Arabs. So, you know, the other nations and the devil, man. Two-thirds, man. Two-thirds of our people, too, man. They're wicked as hell. Only with thy eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. You know, so this whole, you know, thing that's going on, I ain't scared of that, man. For to get it or to get it. You know, but we have faith. We have faith in Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. You know, this devil's going now, man. This place is done. Let me get my last precept here. Alright, Ecclesiastes 12 and 1. Remember now thy Creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor for the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them, while the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain, in the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease. You know, that's the work, because they are few. You know, that's when work is, that's when the work is low. You know, you're grinding out there trying to make a dollar, man. You know, this is the time we're coming to. And the grinders cease because they are few. And those that look out of the windows be darkened. And the door shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the grinding is low. Slakia, that's actually when the work is low. Slakia. When the sound of the grinding is low. You know, and that's when also the businesses, right? You know, you can see the businesses are, you know, closing down because of the so-called thing that happened. You know, it's going to get worse. All these businesses, all the work, you know, they want to automate Uber drivers, Lyft drivers, want to make robots serve you coffee. You know, it's all going to get crazy, man. What was I? Start from the top again. And the doors shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the grinding is low, and he shall rise up at that voice of the birds, and all of the daughters of the music shall be brought low. You know, even music, you know, music's, can't tell you last time I really listened to these new artists, man, but music right now is garbage, man, complete garbage. It's getting worse and worse, you know. All they talk about is one thing, fuck your bitch, you got money. It's all foolishness, man. All corrupts the mind. Also when they shall be afraid of that which is high, and fear shall be in the way, and the almond tree shall flourish, and the grasshopper shall be burdened, and the desire shall fail. You know, and that's what desire to what? Get a house, you know, have your own business. You know, your desire is going to fail because you're going to see what's, you know, happening in this place. You know, it's going to be waste of time, because man goeth to his long home, and mourners go about the streets. You know, so I'm gonna end it off there, man. I'm gonna close it off with this precept here. I'm gonna end off in Matthew 24. Matthew 24 and 12. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. You know, and the love of many is waxing cold right now, because, you know, a lot of people on the streets killing each other, man. There's a lot of crime is increasing, you know. Blood is increasing in the streets, like that guy said. Verse 12. But he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. You know, so your brothers keep pushing, you know, keep pushing, you know, because we're almost out of this place, man. We're almost out of this shitty kingdom, man. You know, I'm trying to be delivered, man. I'm hoping I'm of the elect and trying to be delivered out of this place, man. You know, because all that's to come in this place is death, man, death and destruction. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. And then the end shall come. You know, so this gospel been preached to the four corners of earth. You know, it's just a matter of time before this devil cuts off the YouTube, internet or whatever you want to call it. You know, and then that's it, man. That's it. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then the end shall come. You know, but with that, hope this video was edifying. Shalom to the next video. Shalom.